This is Adrian Kalisa's production.
I'm just trying to kick it with the real girl. That's still classic, classic, classic. You're hitting my line with all these lies. I'm the only man that makes love to your mind.
You do me, and I do me. I got for no business out to kick this. She has been very good, exceptional. Like, the Oprah Winfrey type of woman. When I say...
Hey, you said her name is T?
Just call her T. Just call her T.
T.
Yes.
T is in tunnel. Tunnel green. Yes. Turn up. Okay. Yes. Hey, T.
How you doing there, Blue?
What's happening, T?
I'm doing wonderful.
We plugged up. Hey, T, you got to understand. You ain't never seen this before. Blue is telling you, I want to do some comedy. I'm trying to do some comedy stuff with him, but we talked about it, and we dropped the CD, and then some other stuff. My life went crazy, and then back home and all this stuff. But I want Blue, I called you. I want you to come out here, though. It's going to come out here, and I want to do a documentary on you. But so funny, I want to do it in L.A. I want to get you out of your comfort zone of Arkansas, get you out here, do a documentary on you. Before, we was going to do that movie, right? And I was like, that movie, remember what's going to come to Melbourne? But it's so much going on, it's easy to come do a documentary. And then that way, people get to know you. Then we start putting you in movies. And we can put that on. I got to jump on the plane. I got my own pad and everything. You just jump on the plane. Boom, boom. I'm right by the ocean. You ain't got to worry about nothing. Boom, pull up, do a documentary, put that out, and then get you in the movie. That's what I'm calling you for. But I just record the conversation.
Hey, okay.
Don't ever get to talk to you.
Then let me ask you this.
What's
what
up?
What would make. I got to shoot a ticket straight from the hip, man, because that's all I got is from the hip. So listen, what would make my life so interesting? To do a documentary, man, because I've done nothing extraordinary, man. You know, I've just been me. I mean, you know, I don't know.
Blue, why?
If you see a success story in that, or man, I'm just trying to make it, man.
All right, so take this out.
If we can turn crumbs to bricks, by all means, let's do it.
Check this out, Blue. What's the population of people in the world? How many people in the world? You know, estimate.
Estimate, wow.
Yeah, how many people in the world? I may need to Google that. Blue, do you know how many people are estimate? Like, what, like 80 billion or something? I don't even know how many people.
Hey, man.
I need to know that number to answer his question. I need to know that number to answer his question.
Hello. I'm in New York. I know it's over 8 million in New York.
All right, it says the world population, I just Googled it. It says the world population is 7.5 billion people. As of June 2017, 7.5 billion, according to the most recent United Nations estimates elaborated by Worldometers. So,
okay,
out of 7.5 billion people, why, Blue, why I'm on the phone with you? For one,
wow.
Okay.
I'm in LA, and you said you were again? You said you were
in New York.
You said
New York?
No. I have a cousin in New York.
Hold on. Well, how did New York get into this conversation? I thought Blue. I thought
no,
she was
no,
Arkansas.
That's what she said she was there.
No, she's over in Compton. She's in Compton.
Compton,
California.
Who's been gangbanging on your team?
Stop.
Not now. Right? I keep it real. I'm not doing it now.
Damn, T, I didn't even know that.
No, God changed me, and the people that I'm gonna keep it real with you. I am very protective of people that I care about, and people that I care about. Sometimes I will flip out, and I would do something, and people hurt the people I care about. I don't like that.
Hey, I totally understand, but I want to know you as a person. Now, what side of the fence were you on? Were you a red rag or a blue rag?
No, I ain't wearing no rag. I ain't wearing no rag. No, I wore the black one. The black rag.
Keep on talking. I got one mouth and two ears, so I'm going to talk once and listen twice.
See, I told you, Blue... Told you, this dude, So I was like, Blue, I believe people only understand. He's the funniest person. You get D.L. Hewley and, I mean, all of them. Kevin Hart ain't got nothing on Blue. And he wonder why I'm on the phone with him.
Hey, listen, I wish that was a strong possibility, but those guys are made it, man. And I'm just, I can say again, man. Agent, man, I always thank you for what you think of me, man. But, dog, I'm just me, man. And I'm just me.
That's all you're supposed to be, man. That's enough.
I want T to protect me, because she sounds like she used to be about that life. Man.
T Packet, right? I guarantee you, right now, wherever she at.
No,
Blue. T, don't leave the house without a strap. Don't get it twisted.
T can't walk with the wolves and fight with the eagles together, man. She ain't packing them. She starts carrying them phones to the bar.
Hold on. I'm gonna tell you the difference between people in the world and the people. And you know what? I read a scripture this morning with my mom, and she said that you cannot lie and tell people of the world one thing, and you represent me as a Christian as another. That's what he said in his word. And I said, okay. But like I told my mom, I said, Mom, nobody's perfect. No one's perfect. I said, the only difference between Christians and people of the world is you know when you did something wrong and you go to God and you have, and see, my thing, I have a very, very hard time going to someone that I felt I did wrong and apologize with, and it has to come from my heart. And then I have to go to God
right.
and ask him to forgive me. That's the difference. People right. don't ask them for forgiveness. They just do what they're going to do and they keep going. So my thing
right.
is God has changed me tremendously. However, and I tell my mom, because I used to say the word but, she said, no, it's no but. He's changed you or you haven't. You can't be straddled with fence, as the old people say. You have to be warm. You can't be warm. You have to be hot or cold. On one side of the fence, you represent God. On the other side of the fence, you represent evil. Which one are you? I represent my God. So she said, if you don't, like a friend told me, and I said, I want to go look for my dog, and I'm going to keep real short. He says, you act like you're indispensable. I said, I am to humans. I don't have to worry about what humans do. I said, however, God gave me six senses, and I don't have to shoot nobody. That was back in the day when I did that. Now, as a black belt in judo, I can defend myself. Even though I am on a walker, my grandson tried me, and I had to put him in a chokehold the other night. Because he tried me. Oh, well, you on the walker and this and that. So I just, okay. I said, go on, leave me alone now. Leave me alone, Jaden. Because I did the same thing to, it was like Deja Vu to his mother. But she kept me.
See.
Yes.
Will you marry me? I mean, I'm just being serious. Hey, and then, you know, listen, I can say this without cursing, but you play my nipples hard, man. I mean, straight up, man. Let's just get married, man. Let's just grow on each other after that, man. What you think about that, man? Hey, listen, you can call all the shots, man. I just like the way you talk, man. I just, hey, man, you got that little guitar right there, man. And you missed that.
Oh, that made the day. Hey, T, that ain't nothing gonna happen today on top of that. What just happened? I guarantee you, ain't nothing today that Donald Trump can do or nobody can do that's gonna top what just happened.
Nope, that's not true.
Hey, Blue, you know the funny thing is?
Yeah.
T is one of those people that never really laughs like that. You know what I'm saying? She's more like OG type, like, you know, like Justin Bradford. You know how Justin Bradford, she always serious when you see her?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, she's more like Justin Bradford, how, like, she pull up on you like, what's up? You be like, damn, calm down. You know what I'm saying? She's more like them kind of people. You know what I'm saying? And she was laughing. She's laughing.
Well, slow down, man. Now, let me shoot this to you. Let me shoot this to you, though, for real, man. So, Dupree called me about 2 Sundays ago.
Yeah.
Ronald Dupree, you remember him?
Yeah.
He was outright banging that track that you and Sid dropped years and years ago, man.
Oh, I'm trying to get that too. Which one? We got several ones, but I'm trying to get the first one upset. But what's your name? No, said, where you from?
Yeah.
Arkansas.
Yeah.
Who you be?
Hey,
nigga,
man.
You a G.
Between that track and the one D-Field dropped about his dad living in Park Crackhead. Oh. Man, those are just classics. Those are just... See, let's see, you on the phone and I need to cuss right now, but don't you hang up.
No, you good, you good. Hey, T, he's off the record. Right now, Blue, cuss all you want. Cause all you want.
Go ahead.
Blue. No,
she said, go ahead. No, hey, when she speaks. Okay, she said.
No.
No filter.
I can decipher when I got the devil on. I can decipher when I got the devil on one shoulder and the Lord on the other. Don't put me in no trick basket.
No, Blue.
Hey, I'm just gonna say, man, classics, man. Hey, Asia, man, those are forever gonna be hood classics, man. Forever. Nuh-uh, T, leave me alone.
All right.
Leave me alone, because if you say I can do that, then by midnight tonight, when I'm sliding pictures to your DM, then you be like, Lord, get behind me. Just stay in your lane, T. All right, stay in your lane.
Hey, she pulled out the LeBron ball. That's the LeBron ball we said.
Stay in your lane, she stay in your lane.
Oh, Blue, don't say it too many times. You forgot what you're talking. She was flashing. Don't say it too many times. She said okay.
Hey,
Blue, she said okay like 9 times. You keep saying, stay in your lane, okay, she gonna quit.
I got that. But see, you tell us you got a little Hispanic in your conversation, though.
I'm 100% black, but my mother's side is Indian.
Oh, crazy horse is what I'm gonna call you.
Blackfoot tribe. But I mean,
you got an Indian in you?
My mother has majority of it because she has green eyes, but my daughter got it. So she's red tone. It missed me, but I have the Blackfoot tribe in me. I know where I originated from, Oregon. And I know on my grandma's side, all of the Indians on my side of the family.
Well, okay then. Pardon
me?
Hey Blue, we about the album. Hey Blue, back to the album. Go back to the album. What are you saying?
Wait a minute! You're taking me out of my zone, man. I'm trying to see how old she is and how soon we need to get married, man. Swear, man. Let me watch my mojo, man. I'm trying to get some options here, man. Hey, but no, Adrian, okay, then let me say this, man. Dupri called me, man, and every time I hear that song, man, it just, hey, man, I don't know what's on y'all.
I strive to be my very best. Dynamic skills that I must flex. Getting back rows in the back tub. Big baby gone, no stress. They're taking my place in rock like it's magic, but ain't laking. Big agent recreating, not a Democrat, but debating, related. But ain't kids, 6 figures going off gin. Sad, we did that, man, that's what kind of introduced me to real, like, where Sad is so crazy, motherfucking ass is out here in LA, right? I never see Sad. Sad is probably 30 minutes away from me, and we don't see each other. We came all from Malvern. That's the fun thing about people from Malvern that come to LA, they don't even fuck with each other. Like, Kenny would say every once in a while, I was like, what's up, Dren? That's it. I be still on the news. I be watching Kenny on the fucking news. Right, and she's right down the street from me, but we only ain't been to their house, they ain't been to my house,
hey,
we ain't went out to lunch, we ain't had a cold beer, nothing.
Wait a minute.
That's crazy.
You know, the positive thing about that is, man, no losers always good losers, man.
Yeah.
Usually, man, you know, I can look at my phone, man, and decipher, do I want to answer this or not? Because you know who's calling you for what, man. So, you know, sometimes I can look at my phone and say, man, I know this conversation is not going to go the way I wanted to go. People just don't call each other anymore to say, how you doing?
Yeah.
Or what's going on? What's going on in your life? When they call, that's for a purpose, man. Right. Hey, you got a couple dollars? Or can you run me over here real quick?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Man, look, I can spot dry land through muddy water, man.
Wow.
Excuse me, Miss T. But, hey, man, that's just what it is, man. I'm old enough to spot dry land through muddy water, man, so I can see the bullshit coming a mile away, man. I can see it, man.
Well, I'm not sure what you're going with that, but I'm cool with Miss T. I'm just saying it's just strange how people... No, Miss T, cool. I see Ken. Come on. What's up? We good. So, Kenny, you good? Like, we ain't got to be a big family out here. It's just strange, though. I said it was strange. I didn't say it was bad. I get it. But it's just strange that I ain't never even seen Sad in California or Kenny out here. And that's strange. And I know with more people out here, I did meet Shy Jones. I bet y'all joined, like, it was like, all right, we hooked up, hook out of the studio or whatever. But people, Arkansas people, when they leave Arkansas, they don't really stay rocking. I don't know. It's just strange. They don't, like, well, you know, but it is what it is. I don't know if that's good or bad. Or I don't really care. We all good. You feel me?
My point is this right here, man. What I was trying to say is, man, you're a good person. So, again, why wouldn't people want to hang out with you? You know, especially if you right there from Malvern, man. You know, Malvern is only like a population of, what, 9,000 people?
Mm-hmm.
So now you want to get up to California and act brand new?
No,
see,
well,
again, man.
Malvern is 9,000. LA is 9 million, and Malvern is 9,000. That's funny. Is that irony?
Come on, man. So, I mean, as small as that is, man, we should always embrace each other, man, to see somebody in another city. Embrace that person, man.
Right.
So, again, man, for somebody not to answer your phone call and not want to hang out with you, man, fuck them.
Well, no, I ain't saying, hey,
I'm saying,
hey,
I'm saying
Blue.
It for you.
You Blue.
Ain't say it, I'm saying
back
it for
up.
You. Fuck them.
Blue, okay. Back up a whole lot. Back to beep, 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 like way back. No, I was just saying it was strange. I didn't say he's annoying my phone calls because last time I called, said he picked the phone up. I'm just saying we don't normally hang out. I ain't saying that said not answer my phone calls or like if I need to reach out to Katie.
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't say no. I just said it was strange that we don't hang out.
Slow me down, man.
Yeah, that's why I said slow you down. Like, no, I mean, ain't no problems. I'm just saying, it's just that you would think naturally we would all be hanging out, but it's not a natural thing for whatever reason. I mean, good or bad or ugly, it don't even matter. We all good. I'm by the ocean, they by the ocean, everybody's got money, everybody's happy. So no one's upset.
Okay.
It's just that strange. You would think, if you move to L.A., Blue, right, next week, if you came to L.A., I would be one of the first people you reach out to, like, what's up? I'm in town, show me around. Right?
Yeah, you would get tired of seeing me, man.
Well,
you would get tired of seeing me, man.
Well,
whenever you do laughing.
Well, I'm just saying, you would tap in with your people, like, what you got going on? I don't know what you got going on. We tap in, woo-woo. So
right.
It's just not like that. But there ain't no problems. Like, man, Kenny and Sam are good. They got their family. He got to worry about his kids. He got time to worry about my black ass. I get it.
Yeah.
It's just the fact that we never talk. We talk maybe once a year, if that. And it's just strange. Ron McClellan. You don't remember Ron McClellan? From Melbourne, Ron McClellan, Don McClellan's son. He's Irish too. We talk once a year. You know what I'm saying? It's just about, I don't know, people from Arkansas just don't, when they leave the state, they don't keep rocking. Cheryl Underwood, the comedian from Arkansas. You know what I'm talking about, Cheryl Underwood?
Is she from Arkansas? I never knew that, man.
Yeah, I talked to her. We from both Arkansas, right? We talk once a year. You know, Cheryl Underwood, the dark skinned comedian. She made a big out. She's out in L.A. We both from Arkansas.
Uh-huh.
We talk once a year. I'm like, what is that? Billy Bob Thornton,
hey,
Malvern, Arkansas. Billy Bob, don't fuck with me. Why is that? I mean, this Malvern people, when they leave Malvern, it's like they don't know you. But then you get back, they know you. And then it's like, what? And this is the strange thing about. It's not just Melbourne, Arkansas, you know, Danny Glover, you know, I mean, the list goes on and on. Maya Angelou. Maya Angelou from Arkansas,
hey,
you know.
Hey, you grabbing me tight right now because, listen, all those folks, I didn't know that.
Wow, Blue, yeah. Maya Angelou is from Arkansas.
I knew she was.
Oh, Danny Glover,
yeah,
Billy Bob Thornton, of course, I believe, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't know that, man.
Oh, I know all the stars from Arkansas. You know me, I keep up with all the people. When they leave Arkansas, if they go big, you know they all come to Los Angeles. So I be trying to figure out who is out here that can kind of help me, because I be helping people out too. I be like, wait, where they at? But like normally 99% of celebrities, they leave Arkansas, they blow up big, they come to L.A. It's not just about California, but they come to L.A.
You know what, man? Now, I want to tell you this. I was looking at T.I.'s video. Hey, I still look at TV, man. I'm a man. I look at TV, man. So I'm looking at this T.I. video, man, and they're showing the landscape of L.A. And I had to call my cousin that lives in Long Beach. I'm like, man, is it real what I'm looking at with all these lights and just the city lights? He's like, yeah, man, that's what it is. I have got to see that, man, and I've never experienced that. Never.
Well, he's like, come on here,
man. Yeah, come on here. Come on here, man.
Yeah.
It's good. It's good. Yeah. No, no, Blue, I want you to come. I want to do a documentary on you. I'm serious. All you got to do is get on the plane, come out here. You ain't whipping out on the stage. You know, and I want to do a documentary on you, but I want to do it in L.A., not Melbourne. Just get you away from your comfort zone. That's why I'm calling you. Back to why I called you. I want you let me know when you fly out. I want to do a documentary on you. And you ain't got to worry about no food, nowhere to stay, none. I mean, I'm going to get you around. I'm going to take you all through downtown Hollywood, Beverly Hills. Oh, my. I'm going to take you to the spots that you ain't going to believe that even exists on the planet Earth. Trust me. You would be like,
hey, man, I just want to see it. Now I have been to some major cities, but I just never been to California, man. Never have, man.
Well, man, Blue, do not die without going to California. I mean, seriously, everybody needs to see it in this one. Just trust me, Blue. Blue, just trust me on this one. I'm going to take you to a spot that you're going to be like, I know you, Blue. You're going to be like, Dren, is this real? I'm like, yeah, this real. Press that button, and you're going to go all the way to the top of 8 floors in 1 second. You're going to be like, what? Press the button. Wow, you gone. I was saying, get up there and shoot Knight up there. What's up, dog? You're like, what the fuck is going on? Telling you, Blue.
You know, it's almost like, but man, it's almost. Yeah, but you know, it's like, you know, you look at people like Chris Stein, like, man, I sure wouldn't want to taste that. You know what I'm saying? And I've done that before. I've had Chris Stein, I've done that. But again, man, it's just, I've seen California, so eventually, man, I'm just about to make my way out that way, man. I'm gonna have to, man.
Hey, this is what I need you to do. Fine, let me know when you can come out here, because I have another project I want to invest in, but I'd rather do this one. Find me, let me know what dates you can come out on, and you know, got life going on. But get you out here, and like I said, you don't have to worry about no accommodations, everything, that's what we say, all the stuff. But I want to do a documentary on you in L.A. with, like, a lot of my L.A. people. I want to introduce you to people in L.A., like T, like you on the phone with.
Yeah.
I want you to sit down with T and top it up with it, straight up. Why are you acting this way, Blue? Why you be cussing all the time? And I want to do an honest answer. Why you be all this stuff? Where you come from? Why's your mama name you Blue? I mean, not Blue. Why's your mama name you Blue?
Well,
you know what I'm saying? All the stuff.
I got to answer for all that. I got to answer for everything you just... But this is my thing. Now, this is my thing. Not for you, Asian.
Yeah.
But it's for you, but it's not for you. So I got to ask T. Sure. Now, I don't hear it in Asian. Do you hear any Southern dialect in Asian?
And Adrian?
she don't know about Adrian. You know what? The Blue is wild.
Oh, Adrian. I apologize.
Good Lord.
Any Southern dialect?
No.
I don't either. And I'm talking about just from the hood, man.
Yeah.
All small, man.
Yeah. But, I mean, you know what? You don't have to hear it. You know what I mean? You don't have to be like, do you think a Southern drawl in my language?
Right. No, I don't. I don't hear nothing. I don't hear nothing. Alex, you ain't music coming out of you, girl.
Bless your heart.
Here we go. Correct.
Okay, I was just trying to figure it out.
Blue,
Blue,
I'm telling you, I got you, dog, but see, she ain't, hey, Blue, Blue is missing an important piece of information. Blue, she has not dated a man for 17 years, okay?
Wait a minute, I'm about to pull over because I can't.
I almost got up all over. I'm dead.
He has the lights on, too.
I'm dead.
Wait a minute. Did you just say that you hadn't dated a man in 17 years?
17 years, well.
Wait a minute.
I'm so close. Hold up now. You know what? I'm going to give you one of it. I dated a guy, and they could not actually go by what I require. All I require is that, you know, I'm family orientated. Then you have to. I can't follow you if you're not following Christ. So if you're not following Christ, I can't follow you. My man got to be following Christ, so I can be able to look up to him and say, yes, my man, and, you know, what you want me to do, baby? What you want me to do? So, see, I've been married, and I spoiled my husband. I used to bring his slippers to him when he got off of work. Make sure his dinner was done. They had his bath water running. Blue, he messed that up. And now, 30 years later, he's talking to my mom. I'm ready to come back home, Mom. You know, she says this tells she knows she want me back. No, bro.
The hell did you say?
No, don't roll like that. And so
not the roll like that. It's on my
I have been out on dates, but I haven't dated a guy like to be serious about it. Let me put it that way. I went on a date, but thank you, sweetheart. You've been in the kitchen for me. And open me.
Nope.
So but I have
now, wait a minute though.
You said dating. I'm not intimate.
She basically she had sex for 17 years.
Yeah, now, Missy, you got to beat that. You got to go get with a preacher or a deacon or something.
He said, a deacon. Kitty, this is Blue. I told you. He said, you know, go get with a deacon. Wait.
No.
Oh, my God.
Deacons, they're not ready.
No, Blue, she didn't try that. Like, she want a war. She don't want no soldier. She want a warrior. It's a difference.
Yes. Well, now look at him. Now, T, now you know what? If you can get to this little rock afterward, I can get you from that. I can get you from that. Just on that table. Because somebody else my friends out in the time of need. Hey, but wait a minute. I'm going to say this. When I first heard that, I thought maybe you was going that way, like the Negro said.
Are you talking about what females? Oh,
yeah.
I gotta have me a warrior, a man.
Yes.
Adam
Eve. Hey, Blue, whatever dude, he gotta be, I'm talking about a stud warrior.
Hey, well, now look here, Miss T. Now, you know, I often thought about reincarnation when I come back, and I thought I'd come back as King Kong. What's
wrong about
that?
Oh. You know what, it is?
I told you, Blue. I keep telling y'all about Blue. Hey, oh my God.
No. Why are you not out here as a comedian? Why are you not out here?
You know what? Just because I'm going to tell you something, and you shouldn't put all your faith in one man. But Adrian told me he had me, man. He told me he had me. And I kind of like wrote it off. But hey, listen, he's back in contact with me, so it must be meant to be.
It is meant to be. Because you know what?
Because
the same way, I haven't known Adrian that long. But when I first spoke with him on the phone now, I knew that, okay, this is the guy that I need in my life. But you know what? We always keep it real with each other.
He
does the thing, and I let him know what I don't do. And he respects that. I'm exclusive. I'm extremely exclusive. But the thing is, he has to do what he has to do, what he's been doing. Don't change up, but he keeps it real with me. That's what I love.
I need you to help me break these chains. God, help me break these chains. Taking pictures of my soul, and now they can't sleep. I'm
tossing and turning, hoping that I reach my destination. It's a cold world, you gotta move quick, no contemplating. California got me paranoid, I'm trying to do my best on that 101 freeway. My mind don't be surprised, just be prepared, cause you know they coming for you. The temptation got me weak, I pray to God for self-esteem. I walk alone in this cold world, searching for my essence. I don't wanna be like everybody else, cause I'm a legend. I might just go off of my instinct, the atheist all in the frenzy. The evil, the drugs, and the life that I'm living, I'd rather be labeled a misfit. Look into my eyes, what do you see? The spirituality. I don't hang with nobody, nobody, nobody. This thug life,
this is the Dren Kalisa's production.